Welcome back. So, in my previous video, I had talked about what are verbs, what are prono suje, and what are the different categories of verbs and what are the different categories of ending. So, in this video, we're going to talk about the first ending. That is, let's see together. The first ending that we have is ER ending verbs. What's that? ER ending verbs. The verbs that end with E. So, if you remember, we have three categories of verbs. The first one being ER ending verbs. The verbs that end with E. So, now we need to learn what's a verb in French first. So, verb, for example, if we take an example of a verb called parler. P-A-R-L-E-R. That means to speak. Parler means to speak. So, when we have the word with the ending er, that's called the infinitive form of the verb. That's called the infinitive form of the verb. That is, the verb is not yet conjugated. The verb is not yet conjugated according to the subject. Now what we're going to do is, we're going to understand the rules associated to conjugate the er ending verbs, and then we'll practice conjugating er ending verbs. Let's see how. For conjugating an ER ending verb is that we need to find the root. We need to find the root of the verb. So what we do is follow a simple rule. We remove the ER from the ending. First, what we need to do? We need to remove ER from verb. Remove ER from verb. Then whatever left, like for example in parler, we have left with par. So P-A-R-L becomes the stem or the root, you can say. Stem or the root of the verb. Par becomes the stem or the root. So now we have par. Now using this stem or the root, what we say, we will conjugate the verb according to the all the subjects that we have. Let's see how we're going to do that. If you remember, the order of the subjects were je, tu, il, elle, nous, vous, ils, and elles. This is how the order of the French sujet what we have. Now, let's begin with a verb called parler. So, je parle. We'll write everywhere the stem or the root. And then we'll put the endings. So, the stem or the root for parler is P-A-R-A. P-A-R-A. So, what we have done is, we have written the parle everywhere. Je parle, tu parle. Now we have written parle everywhere, that's the root of the noun. Now we have to learn the ending. So we have the endings with je, we have the ending as e. Then with tu, we have the ending as es. Then with il, we have the ending again as e. El ending is again e. Then with nu, we have the ending as ons. Then with ze, vu, we have the ending as ez. And with ils and els, we have the ending as ent. So I'll repeat the endings first. Je, e, tu, es, il, e, el, e, nu, ons, vu, ez, ils, els, ent, ils, els, ent. Now let's see how we pronounce it. Je parle, tu parle, il parle, elle parle. Nous parlons. Nous parlons. Vous parlez. Il parle. Elle parle. This is how we conjugate. We'll repeat it once more. Je parle. Tu parle. Il parle. Elle parle. Nous parlons. Vous parlez. Ils elles parlent. So this was all about the endings of ER ending verbs. Now let's see one more ending. One more verb Then we work on the exceptions of ear-ending verbs. Now, I have taken the verb as danser, D-A-N-S-E-R, danser, which means to dance. Now, we have written the subject in the order. Now, we are writing the stem or the root, that is D-A-N-S, because E-R is removed. Nu dance, who dance. Now, we will work on the endings. So, je danse, tu danse, il danse, nous dansons, vous dansez, ils dansent. Je danse, tu danse, il danse, nous dansons, vous dansez, ils dansent. So, this was all about ER ending verbs. Now, you have learned the rule. The rule says the endings are E, ESE, ONS, EZ, ENT. This was the endings from the order of the subject. Je, tu, il, nous, vous, ils, elles. So, this is all about the ER ending verbs. Now, let's work around the exceptions that we have in ER ending verbs. So, the major exception of the verb that we have is with the word ale. With the word ale. So, I'll write it a little bigger. Ale means to go. Ale means to go. The verbs you see is ending with ER, but unfortunately it doesn't follow the rules that we have for ER ending verbs. Endings doesn't suffice in this rule, in this verb. Let's see how. Is it conjugated? So it is conjugated like je vais, which means I go, tu va, tu va, which means you go in a singular way. Then it is il va, he goes, elle va, she goes. Then we have nous allons, which means we go. Then we have vous allez, you go in the plural. Then we have ils vont, they go in the masculine, and elles vont, they go in the feminine plural. So how do we say it? Je vais, tu vas, il va, elle va, nous allons, nous allons, vous allez, ils vont, elles vont. This is how the exception to it is ending. Now, next exception that we need to learn is that there are some ER ending verbs that end with GER. That ends with GER. So, what change do they follow? Let's see that. So, we have a verb called manger, that is ending from G-E-R. Manger means to eat. So, what the change is there? Rest everything remains the same. All the endings remain the same. The rules for making the stem remains the same. Just different change that we have is with nu. Nu, if it would have been a normal ER ending verb, it would be nu, M-A-N-G, because we remove the O-R and we end the N, O-N-S, nu manger. But what is added in it is with G, it an extra E is added. So it becomes nu mangions. Instead of O-N-S, the ending is E-O-N-S. Only in the verbs that are ending with G-E-R. Not with all ER ending verbs, only the verbs that are ending with GER will have this change. Only with NU, rest all will remain same with conjugated for JU. We'll quickly see the conjugation for it. How it is it? JE MANGE M-A-N-G-E TU MANGE M-A-N-G-E-S Il mange, M-A-N-G-E, elle Mong, M-A-N-G-E again. Noop, Mongio. The difference that I told you. Noop, Mongio. Boop, Mongje. Everything remains the same. It is just the change comes with noop. Is Mong and S Mong. So, je mange, tu manges, il, elle mange, nous mangeons, vous mangez, il, elle mange. So, this was all about the ER ending verbs. Similarly, in the next video, we're gonna see how IR ending verbs works. Thank you. Bye.